بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على حبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وأصحابه وعلى من اتبع الهدى أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته In this short video, I'll be touching upon a very important and sensitive topic which I get asked many times in our Darul Iftah is related to intrusive thoughts of divorce. So what that basically means is that many people, they have this misgiving, they have this waswasa about divorce, and you know, it begins to play in their mind that whether they've actually divorced their wife or not. Or for example, let's say a woman that she's constantly thinking about whether her husband has divorced her or not, she's not sure. So for instance, let's say that either a person is thinking about divorce in his heart, in his mind or in his heart, thinking that just by that assumption and just by that thinking that a man has ended up either divorcing his wife, or for example a person is having just a normal conversation and certain conversations and certain words that's used in a general conversation is triggered these thoughts of divorce, right? So this is basically waswasa of people have that whether divorce is taking place or not. So that's what I just wanted to clarify in this short video. So just to mention that the ulamas and the scholars say, and to my understanding, that this is the standard opinion across the board, across all of the schools of thought, is that just by a person mere thinking about a divorce in the mind or in the heart, the divorce does not take place. Just by thinking about the divorce, divorce does not take place. The condition for divorce is that a person has to either utter the clear words of divorce or uses certain ambiguous terms of divorce whereby he made the intention of divorce. So for example, let's say there's a heated argument between a husband and wife, and there's shouting going on between them two, there's an intense argument going on between the two, so much so that the husband says, pack your bags and get out the house, I don't want to see you anymore. And at that particular moment, if he was questioned what he meant at that time of divorce, that he wants to end this marriage, only at that particular instant that divorce takes place, otherwise not. Likewise, if the husband, for example, if he wrote divorce in clear words that I so-and-so person have divorced so-and-so person and so on and so forth, right? Okay, only in these particular moments or times and occasions that where divorce takes place. So otherwise, thinking about divorce in itself, in the mind or in the heart, or just having a casual conversation, whether it be about food or anything, and certain words, they just trigger the thoughts of divorce in the mind, then the divorce does not take place at all. So that is the clear masala. But now the question is that why is it that do people have certain intrusive thoughts? One of the reasons is because many people, they begin to over-contemplate, overthink of certain things. You see, whenever a thought comes to mind, the first thing what a person should do is a person should try to discard it. The first time that a thought has ever come to mind, then it's easy to discard it at that time. Never ever contemplate over it. Because the moment you begin to over-contemplate over something, you begin to start over-analyzing certain matters, then, and going to the intricate details, that's when a person now becomes drowned and submerge into those thoughts. So much so that a person now, if they want to try to get out of those thoughts, it becomes very, very, very difficult. So it's the same thing when it comes to divorce. Our Sharia Islam has made things very easy for us, because any thoughts that come to the heart and mind, the Sharia has not made us responsible for that until a person doesn't put them into actions, or a person does not utter them. And there's a beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that one companion came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam complaining about certain thoughts that comes to his mind, that if he was to utter those words, then it will end up making him a disbeliever. I mean, negative thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, negative thoughts about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and things like that. So he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam inquiring. What did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? Inna Allah tajawaza an ummati ma waswasat bihi suduraha ma lam ta'am The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that verily Allah, and this is reported from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, and it's a hadith, it's reported from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, it's mentioned in Sunan of Abu Dawud and Muslim and so on, that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has pardoned my ummah, pardoned my nation of the waswasas, the intrusive thoughts that come into the mind, ma lam ta'mal bihi aw tatakallam, so long as he does not enact them and so long as he does not speak of them. The moment when a person brings those thoughts into action, the moment a person begins to verbally express his thoughts, that's when a person now becomes responsible, regardless of however it is. Now, the context of the hadith was about a sahabi having doubts that related to faith, matters of faith. And when it comes to divorce, which is relates to a legal matter in itself, so even if a person is just thinking about it but not uttering it, then according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a person is not responsible, the divorce does not take place. So my dear brothers and sisters, for those of you who are For those of you out there who are suffering from intrusive divorce, do not begin to over contemplate, right? That's the key thing to know. So there's just a few recommendations I want to mention. The first thing is, as I mentioned, is that not to overthink by dwelling deeply into intricate details. Why? It's because as Muslims, we are not responsible for investigating too much detail into a matter in searching for solutions. Because by doing that, you will end up overwhelming yourself. You start overwhelming yourself, which the Sharia itself does not want us to do. And remember the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's a beautiful hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, anything that comes into the, any thoughts that come into the heart and mind, then Allah SWT has already forgiven. Allah SWT has already forgiven them, right? So this is not our Sharia aims, right? Like it's a beautiful verse of the Quran comes to mind where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, Taha ma anzalna alayka al-Quran litashqa. It's the second verse of Surah Taha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states that we have not revealed the Quran upon you so to burden you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying this to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then likewise all the Islamic laws and the ahkams that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for us, they are not there to burden us. So we ourselves should not overburden ourselves by overthinking of intricate details. So as Muslims, we are not responsible to dwell into that degree of scrutiny. So that's number one. Number two, refrain from reaching out towards that which you cannot attain. When you go into too much of the details into the thought, you're trying to reach out to something which you cannot attain. And when you're not able to attain that, you feel that discomfort and that dissatisfaction. So you're not satisfied. So people begin to assume and think, right, that the more details I go into, then the more it's going to satisfy me. But rather that is the that's the contrary. I know certain brothers and sisters, what they've done is they've actually gone through every single website, a fatwa website that they know of about this divorce matter, thinking that the more detail I go into, then it's going to be better for me. But rather that is very harmful, very dangerous. In these particular moments, it's always better to speak to an alim or a scholar or somebody who's an expert in dealing with OCD and dealing with OCD and intrusive thoughts. And that is the solution, so they can present some kind of remedies for you in order to remedy the problem. So the second is that refrain from reaching out towards that which you cannot attain, because detail matters you can never ever attain. Number three is that judge according to that which is apparent to you, right? So as I mentioned, as a principle rule, is that until a person does not speak of those words clearly with the intention that he's going to divorce his wife, for instance, right? Because there's an argument that's taking place or he utters those words of divorce clearly, right? By using the word talaq and divorce, for instance, addressing his own wife, then until that doesn't happen, the divorce does not take place. So once a person was to utter those words clearly, that's when divorce takes place. So in Islam, we only judge by what according to what is apparent to us. Number four is learn to be positive about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many of these people, when they go into too much of the details of thoughts of divorce, or even for example when it comes to spiritual purity, people have this notion that, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to be angry with me? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to punish me if I continue in this relationship? Or is Allah ta'ala going to punish me that if I pray my salah without wudu and so on and so forth as a result of these intrusive thoughts? Know that we should always have a positive thinking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not hold anyone responsible beyond their natural capacity. Yes? Allah Ta'ala does not hold anybody beyond their natural capacity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very merciful to us, and he never punishes people. Yes? On that basis. And likewise, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just to reiterate, that inna Allah tajawaza an ummati ma waswasat bihi suduraha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven and pardoned the waswasa that comes in the heart. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already forgiven that shows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's magnificent mercy. And this is something we should always think. So in short, number four is be positive about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't worry about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishing and so on and so forth. Allah ta'ala will only punish a person and hold a person responsible for them doing something that they know they're doing something wrong intentionally. Yes? Number five, each time that a thought to divorce comes to mind, then always say ta'awudh. Say a'udhu billah. Every time that whenever these thoughts come to mind, say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, seek ta'awudh all the time, because these waswasas come from shaitan. And there's a beautiful dua. And by the way, I've written a detailed fatwa on intrusive thoughts, and there's a dua, it's available on our fatwa website, and there's a beautiful dua that I've recorded from the Quran, where Allah Ta'ala says, Rabbi a'udhu bika min hamazat ash-shayateen wa a'udhu bika rabbi an yahdurun, which translates to, oh Allah, I take refuge in you from the whispers of the devils, and also seek refuge with you, my Lord, that they are present. So this is a very powerful dua. So any dua that you know of, even if you don't know the Arabic, even if you say the English, even that, inshallah, that will be sufficient. So constantly dhikr, do dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anytime that the thought comes, say, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, and read the dua, Rabbi a'udhu bika min hamazat ash-shayateen, wa'udhu bika rabbi an yahdurun. Right? So read these du'as and just follow these basic remedies, and inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make everything easy for you. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.